can remember. Miss Barry Smith. And you don't need that water.
My throat is very dry because I had a cold and I didn't want to give you a cold, Miss Palace.
Your glass of water, so
you're not supposed to drink water when you sing. It's your
own state. My throat's dry.
All of our throats are dry, Barry.
But you're not. Well, never mind. I know.
You want to stand?
Yes, please.
You can ask for it back. Say that's what you'll get rid of your nerves by walking.
It's true, huh?
You know, like walking on stage on Norma, for instance, if they cut that out, whew, the first act doesn't have a... No? But... you're not supposed to have anything once you sing. No, in fact, I'm going to tell a story of, which is true, it happened to me. I was singing Aida for the first time with Maestro Serafin in Torino, and the Celi Azzurri is very difficult, I must confess. There are other pieces that are more difficult, but I was young too, and so I ordered myself a cognac, because somebody told me that it would give me courage. So Maestro Serafin saw it pass by his dressing room. He says, "Who's that cognac for?" So they told him, "It's for Miss Callas." I was Miss then. I am Miss now, too. he says, "Take that back." And he comes very angry in my dressing room and told me, this is how you get into the bad habit. First of all, of not using your muscles, reflexes, and for once you start drinking one cognac, and the next time it won't be enough, you'll be drinking two, and by that time you'll hit the bottle. And it's very true of very many of my colleagues. Well, I said very many, not who. No, but it's true, by drinking, you don't use the... I hope not.
No, honey, I swear.
Gee whiz. You know, when I practice, I have nothing. So now let's get back down to earth. To earth and to work.
Questi gli ultimi tuoi.
learn it?
I learned it yesterday, which is obvious.
Grant her that much, eh? Very good. Now, shall we break it down a bit?
Yes.
You must remember to tie together the words to the notes. In other words, don't chop. Ah, perfido. A little
I'm
more.
I'm not particularly in Barbaro
Traditore.
I get
tied up in Anyway, you understand? And then, in no way should you get unsupported in the sound. Later on, you were trying to calm yourself, so you are unsupporting. I'll come to that eventually. Eh? But it should be, for instance, to give you an example. Where is it exactly when it comes back? Every time, there's three times I think it comes back. Non devo tanto affanno, non sono di pietà. Have to keep it always steady, legato, and supported. So now we go back. Eh? And more solemn. Such terrible tyranny. So there are three colors within the classicism of the piece. And don't ever leave your voice again without supporting it with vibrating the sound. Huh? Try it again.
Getting better.
in yourself and sing, please. Come on. Come on. Sing. Circle it so you'll not make that. After that, eh? Always authority, eh? Before the accelerato. Allegro assai. Please. Here, there's ignore the public. We're here to learn. Eh? Io già le godo immaginando e pomeriggio vengo giocare in orti intorno.
Care for this? I'm not bringing on to the rest of it, but you can do the cantabile.
You don't feel like it? Past so much that I don't absorb.
All right.
But also, let me start on this.
I would like you to start at least on this, just in the beginning, to give you an idea. Steadier, be careful on your te also.
Per pietà.
You say ta.
Per pietà.
pietà. Non dirmi addio, non dirmi addio. Piti,
the same thing.
Piti primo che farò. Piti primo che farò.
This is just all of you that, so also good for you too, Sheila. One not Kirkham, eh?
I would rather work hard.
I would prefer to. But it's excellent. Only be careful on your pronunciation. And when you slow down, it should always be a pulsation underneath. Even now. Keep on. All right? I would like also, I'm putting especially this assignment, shall we say, because it keeps you on the classical side instead of pushing the voice or pulling it with opera. Sometimes you might get into bad habits. This confines you to a more steady way of singing also, which is, I think, what Barry needs right now. You know, pulling a little here and there. Oh, Sheila, you also should start learning it, eh? Eh? Well, you can buy it. I don't know if you find them at the stores, but anyway. But you got the idea. Very good, Barry, eh? I would like to hear Mr. White, only I'm afraid that we don't have your Nabucco. Two only. You know it out by heart? Do you feel like singing? Are you all right? Please. We'll be improvising, eh? I want to make one thing clear. No, this is for all of you, all of you people of mine. When I have these classes, you don't know how long they will last. All right, now we know. I don't know whether I will be back. I hope I will. That's beside the point. If you people think sometimes that auditioning or taking absence of leave, unless you're ill and proven, I cannot accept. And as I cannot make an exception for one, it has to be a rule for everyone. So you'll have to make up your mind whether you care more about these classes or auditioning. Understand? And I'm not saying any names, but you have to make up your mind. What is more important? These kind of classes or your auditioning here and there? If I were you, I would sit here and learn and audition later when I've known a little more. Don't you think? Now, to whom it may concern, you've understood exactly. I give no absence of leave unless it's sickness to anyone. Got it? So, as I cannot, unless, for instance, there is Miss Anita Tertian, who has a concert tonight, and that I gave her permit. But I don't like to make it a rule. These are classes that are 6 weeks in two periods, and you should take advantage as much as you can. And I think these are more important than your having auditions when you might flunk a chance. So, no exception made, eh? So don't ask me, or if you fail for two classes, I'm afraid I'll have to not accept you anymore, eh?
Oh.
Again, the sound must be more rounder, firmer. Eh? I hear too much of the ta, the same thing that you realize it. Eh?
I noticed that I can control.
Yeah, and you should sing with more solemnity. Eh? The whole attitude. This is a great priest, so vieno levita, with much more authority, and keep your sound ringing. Eh? Keep it always vibrant. Can you work on that now? Let's see what you do. Sing the whole thing well. More vibrant. But the attitude is the same kind of monumental attitude. Because you know what it's about. So it's solemn what you're saying. So go ahead.
Yes.
syllables. Keep the vowels going. Messer Momanda.
Messer Momanda, per gloria di Israele. Should be even more firmer, even though it's not so loud. Tutto sottovoce, but it's firm. In fact, there's an accent on top, did you see? Sforzando, eh? Tu, tu.
Phrasing also. Eh? As I say, I didn't want to force the voice, my voice, because then I have to sing tomorrow, but it should be round and you should have much authority in what you say there. Eh?
I'll work on that.
You know what the words are?
Yes, I do. Thank you.
All right. Miss Nadler, or as you wish, who feels like first, because I have to take them, and or Akiko Iku.
Who feels like it?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, yes, what do you have? The butterfly, eh? Face the public, please. Drive, huh? So but faster, eh? Can't you breathe there? It's a long phrase, eh?
Yes.
And you have to, I'm afraid you'll have to give it more power there, eh? You take away the e, pan, e. E.
Pan, e, vestimento.
Very dramatic.
E butterfly, orribile destino, danzerà per te. Very nervous, very desperate. Same approach of a perfido. The
crescendo there. You want to do it again? My cue. Let's see if you can get the la more concentrated, but better. Always sing the notes up on top, eh? Okay. Never.
Yeah, scoop. Yeah.
Never from under.
Okay. Thank you very much.
I still think, though, also that you should keep the voice limber, eh?
Limber?
In other words, work the voice with your exercises, too, eh?
Yes.
Not only on butterfly.
More.
All right. Don't forget that. For
thank you.
expressing something. Eh?
That low part
was, yeah, it's not a matter of low part here. It's the whole attitude. You should put more spirito. Eh? It's not my aria, but it should be sung with, you know, spirit and with grace. Can you manage to understand what I mean? Eh? It's too harsh to attack. It should be marcato, yes, but. Saracino stelo piano, but supported. Play more with the words in Barbiere di Siviglia. This is not exactly Barbiere at all, but it should be played with grace and with perfume, you know, elegance. So if you don't give these light colors, then it's amneris all the time. No comments, okay? Nel giardin. Cadenza also is very good. Now you have to play with it. It was very good, but you have to play. No, it was not at all a disaster, only you're vocalizing. Now you have to play with it elegantly. So we'll come to that. Nel giardin.
Nel giardin.
if you were up here, you wouldn't like it. Don't take away from the rest. It should always be.
Yes,
you're a woman. Elegant. Mohamed Remorse. Please give her a. Less rigid. Why did you scoop up to that? It was much better, but why did you scoop on the thigh again? I do it because this is not my island, but it should be playful, in other words, playful. Which justifies the rest, eh? Cadenza, please. Grazia. And the cadenza is very good now. It's much better. You can even sing it more on the light side. The beginning. Well, go on. Did it second? No, all right. Second. Ma di scherna pena.
it's much better already.
Sei il tuo cuore.
Up, generoso now.
Sei il tuo cuore, vorrò pittare in un cuore.
Crescendo or diminuendo, usually a little bit of that. Anima, in other words, give it more life. All right? Cadenza again. You have to bring more spirit into it, more spiritoso.
Thank you.
sure about it. Eh? Is it clear? I'm sure it's clear. You got it?
Thank you very much.
But it should be giocone, giocoso, playful.
Only problem is that
no problem.
Think of.
If you think of what you're singing, of the words, and what goes through, then you'll see it will not be difficult at all. Don't be preoccupied about the notes. They're there, though you know the song. The perfume that you must give it, eh? The elegance. And you saw it.
Thank you.
Lenny, you feel like singing? Eri tu? Well, you can do that backstage.
Not here.
No, not here. No. You want to go a little bit backstage and loosen up?
Alzati, la tua figlia a te concedo riveder. Nell'ombra del silenzio là, il tuo rosso relonta mia nascondi.
Thank you.
down to expression. Because you were singing all in one power, eh?
Yeah, you haven't got any nuance today.
Eh?
Yeah.
Alzati, là è tuo figlio, a te concedo di riveder nell'ombra del senso. Should be after.
Non è sulle.
Shall we go little by little? Alza. Alzati, la tuo figlio a te concedo. It's a recitativo. Alzati,
alzati, il tuo la tua figlio
la a te tuo figlio, la tuo figlio a te concedo riveder.
Alzati, la tuo figlio. Alzati.
Alzati. Yeah, you have to be more. You have to find the sound. Alzati.
Alzati. La tua figlio a te concedo riveder.
Nell'ombra. Nell'ombra. Sol bemol, G and G flat. So you have to watch that. Something with a sound that makes you under the tone. So you have to sing it higher. Altro.
Altro. Altro sangue. Atelger desi lo fesa.
Should not be here. Here it's rounder, it's more human. And a man in love. understand the atmosphere that I would like? That Verdi would like? Dalle lagrime mie! You give it too much dynamic.
All right.
You're banging it out too much. Eh? Dalle. E lo trarrà.
Primo.
the attitude is good. He's talking of this wonderful love. Mm-hmm. Amplesso, exactly, you know what it means. Complete love. Mm-hmm. Complete.
Embrace.
Exactly, which means everything. So it should be the most passionate but sweet, said with dolcezza. Eh? Start from Eritu. Excuse me, no, I'm sorry, it's my bad. I'm after. It's the expression. Your voice would not have passed.
suffering of having lost his love. He loved very much, he loves her very much, and this is a mature man that's singing. So the sound must be round, always, very beautiful, but not gagliardo. Mm-hmm. You understand? Mm-hmm. So the whole aria has to be worked down into different dynamics.
Yes.
This is completely different from the credo. This is a man that suffers. Now, I know you're young, but nevertheless, you still have to suffer. Because you're acting. And a good actor is, you suffer, yes, partially. The mind is always controlling you. But you must suffer the part. You must be the part itself. So the phrasing has to be exactly suffering with the legato and espressivo and not too forte. Round the sound. Did you understand, though?
Mm-hmm.
Do you have any doubts?
No, I don't.
But you saw the difference of before and the difference now.
Mm-hmm.
Do you see the attitude of the aria?
Mm-hmm.
Have you seen, are there any questions?
No, I don't think so.
You
it's
must really take...
It's a technical problem.
Well, it's because the expression is different that you have to work also the technical part.
Mm-hmm.
So up to now you were just banging the aria out, or as they vulgarly say, belting it out. Now you should not do that, you should bring it down to its essential, which means expression, the man that's suffering, he's lost his love, he's still in love, he's vindicative. You understand?
Mm-hmm.
So this is why the voice is not corresponding to what you want.
Mm-hmm.
You'll have to break it down in your mind and bring it down to normal. In fact, if you do have an audition, if you do have, I said if, not in this aria yet.
Mm-hmm.
Understand what I mean,
mm-hmm.
Lenny? Take time to study your things, your arias, the whole role as a conception. Once you have everything in order, contracts will come pouring in, don't worry. But first, the technique has to be done. Technique together with expression especially. And it's not Marcello now.
Mm-hmm.
This is a very human part. So it takes a lot of reasoning, a lot of thinking, and a lot of suffering. Plus, building together a complete different technique, because you have to do some piani and a lot of legati. All right?